date was 11 March 2011.
Fusion is 72 kilometers east of Oshika Peninsula of Tohoku, Japan. Time was 14:48, 6 minutes. The ground shook underwater. Underwater earthquake has occurred, strongest ever recorded in Japan. Measuring at a magnitude of 9.1, it was also the fourth largest earthquake ever recorded. The earthquake moved the island of Honshu by 2.4 meters, shifted the Earth axis, increased its rotational speed, as well as sunk the Pacific Ocean of Honshu. It also generated a huge tsunami of up to 40.5 meters and traveled up to 10 kilometers inland. Talk about a powerful earthquake. Japanese authorities reported more than 50,000 deaths, 6,000 injured, and 2,500 missing. More than 121,000 collapsed buildings, 180,000 half-collapsed. Talk about earthquake-proof and tsunami-preventive buildings. The most dramatic building collapse would definitely have been the Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Power Station, which we are going to talk about today, as well as the Fukushima 50. Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Power Station is a nuclear power station managed by the Tokyo Electric Power Company. It has 6 reactors with a combined capacity of 4.7 gigawatts. Okay, some of the largest nuclear power stations in the world. When the earthquake hit, all 6 reactors will automatically shut down. As per their design, once shut down, the reactors will be cooled by the external diesel power generators. A 30-meter tsunami hit the power plant, flooding these diesel generators, decommissioning them, and eventually causing a meltdown in reactor 1, 2, 3. Fortunately, the diesel power generators for reactor 6 was well protected. As workers struggled to prevent meltdown, TEPCO withdrew non-essential workers, leaving behind 50 essential staff, nicknamed Fukushima 50. Fate rarely calls upon us at the moment of our choosing, but the Fukushima 50 stayed behind to stop a disaster. Numbers eventually increased to several hundreds with assistance from other corporations. An honorable mention can be made for plant manager Masao Yoshida. Masao Yoshida has been criticized by some medias over his weak leadership post-tsunami. Like sister plant Fukushima Daiichi, he successfully averted meltdown. Masao Yoshida was criticized for his slow actions which led to the meltdowns. This is a huge shame to his actions. Masao Yoshida had to operate in never seen before situations. The Fukushima 50 existed because of him. Protecting then Prime Minister Nato Khan behind the backs of TEPCO executives wanted to evacuate the plant. At one moment, Masao Yoshida offered to lead the suicide squad to cool down the reactors. The single biggest decision that changed the course of history was his defiance against TEPCO executives who wanted him to stop using seawater to cool down the reactors, as doing so would permanently damage the reactors. It is this defiance that eventually led to the cold shutdown of the reactors. For that defiance, Yoshida was officially reprimanded by TEPCO. 9 months after the accident, Yoshida retired from his position due to esophagus cancer. On July 9, 2013, at the age of 58, Masao Yoshida died from cancer.